everyone. Today is 22nd of April and the time is 7:15 in the evening. So, मैंने आज live trading video क्यों नहीं बनाया? Because I took a huge hit. So, we took almost 86,000 loss. अगर आप funds देखोगे, तो the funds used were around 21 lakhs. So, which is almost slightly above 4% of the deployed capital. And the expiry was pretty bad for me. Nothing went well and nothing went as per my expectation. And also, even in the bank Nifty account, we took a hit of around 8,000 rupees. So in total, we booked the loss of around 94,000 and including all the charges and stuff, we booked the loss of around 1 lakh. All right, which is close to 4% of the combined capital. You know, I never usually intend to take a loss anything more than 2%, but today we started off only with the wrong foot. Alright, so पहले क्या हो गया? तो पहले जो orders मैंने exit कर रहा था, तो पहले मैंने जब orders execute कर रहा था, उस time पे I got huge slippages because 5-5 second के लिए my orders were get stuck in this validation pending. Zerodha में validation pending करके मेरा सारे orders stuck हो रहे थे, and because of that I got around 100 points slippage in Bank Nifty, and I got around 20 point and 10 points slippage in Nifty as well. So the quantities were around 3,600 quantities there. And with that quantity, I was already looking at around 20K loss as soon as I started out. And jab ye jo candle aaya, just a minute. And when this candle formed, it was my mistake that I was not very agile, because isi point pe main actually main thoda cautious hona chahiye tha, because it was halting around the higher levels and it was this breakout was kind of about to happen. But yahan pe maine, as we say, satark nahi tha, and because of that the calls got spiked way too much than I could handle, and wahi se main almost like I was sitting at almost 3% loss. And as and when the markets went higher and higher, I used to keep adjusting, and almost maine 100 plus orders maine adjustment karna pada, almost 100 orders place karna pada. And even after so many adjustments, I used to get a lot of slippages. Slippages mein bhi thoda bahut paise chala gaya. And also because the call IVs were spiking and the puts were not decaying, because the entire market's consensus, the whole consensus was bearish. So, sab log ye soch rahe the ki weekend pe SGX ko dekh ke ye soch rahe the ki yeah, like we might also head to somewhere around 14,000 today. So, when we opened, you know, we opened at around 14,200, which was better than anyone could expect. So we were all expecting like we would be opening somewhere at 14,100 or something, but suddenly we opened at 14,200, and everyone expected that we might at least get sold into at least up till 14,100 or 14,050. But that didn't happen. After the first 5 minutes of sell-off, that this dip got clearly bought into, and this got bought into more than anyone could expect, and that triggered the short covering rally. So as they say, be fearful when everyone else is greedy and be greedy when everyone else is fearful. That has exactly worked out in the market today. Our view was not particularly bearish. So we didn't think that market will go down, so we'll short calls aggressively. No. We were completely delta neutral. Alright. Even then, the call IVs were spiking way too high and the puts were not at all giving up their value, because there was so much demand for puts. Everyone kept buying the puts at every rally. So basically everyone started thinking, okay, yahan pe 20 moving average hai, yahan pe retrace ho jayega niche. To jaise ye candle form ho gaya, ye red candle form ho gaya, just a minute. To jaise ye red candle form ho gaya, to immediately puts spike up ho rahe the. And then CPR ke paas aaya, ye red candle form ho gaya, puts spike up ho rahe the. Ye red candle form ho gaya, spike up ho rahe the. So the puts were not particularly decaying in the value, but the calls were expanding up till the last minute. So because of that, we took a huge hit, and also thanks to Zerodha. Aajkal Zerodha mein problems are pretty frequent nowadays. So har ek hafte mein ya once in fortnight we are getting stuck with either like the order issues, or the order getting stuck in the validation pending thing, or you know, the platform itself getting hanged, some other thing, and sometimes NSC. So there are so many things stacked against us. And मैंने live trading video इसलिए नहीं बना पाया, because I was kind of frustrated with Zerodha first, and then I was kind of frustrated with myself because I didn't observe this move. ये जो move था, इस move में मेरे call unwinding हो गया, and I took a lot of damage in that. And after that, it just spiraled down. At one point of time, this MTM was somewhere around 1.2 lakhs negative, but somehow I managed to get this back to this. And after some point of time, I squared up my position exactly at 130. If I had sat through the end of the trading session, I would have got back at least 50% of this. I would have at least made like 50% of what I had lost. At least 40k to aa jata tha, because 10 points premium collect karna in the last 2 hours is not that difficult. Since my mental state was not supportive and I wasn't sure that I would not be making any further mistakes, so that's why I came out of the trades and called it a day. So even bank nifty account mein to kafi jaldi maine 954 ke aas paas hi maine almost bank nifty mein strength dikh raha tha. So that's why I closed everything and I saw that the puts were not decaying and the calls were spiking way too much. तो मैंने इमीडिएटली मैंने क्लोज कर दिया था. अगर इसको भी मतलब मैं एडजस्ट करते बैठता तो इसमें भी ऑलमोस्ट और एक 20,000-25,000 तक लॉस हो जाता था. बट थैंकफुली वी डिडंट टेक मच ऑफ अ हिट इन बैंक निफ्टी अकाउंट में सिर्फ अराउंड 2% हिट ही लिया है. बट ऑन निफ्टी अकाउंट वी टुक 4% विच इज वेरी बैड. ऑलराइट, यूजुअली 4% या यूजुअली मेरे हिसाब से 2.5% के ज्यादा होना नहीं चाहिए. एंड अनदर थिंग व्हाट आई हैव अंडरस्टूड इज माय साइकोलॉजी इज नॉट at its optimum level whenever I start with a huge red candle. That too because of someone else's mistake. Because when I entered the trade, it was not my mistake. Yes, let's make sure that these kinds of drawdowns don't happen in the future. So today I'm gonna set a rule. Even though I'll be trading non-directionally, the moment I reach a 2% loss, I'm gonna be calling it a day from now on. So from now on in my channel you won't be seeing any loss which is more than 2% of the deployed margin. So that's the takeaway for you guys, and I hope that your expiry was much better than what I had. So aapka jo expiry hai itna bada losses na ho, aapka expiry mein profit ho, that's what I wish and that's what I hope. If you have to take away something from this video, it's that ki bro, strategies hone do, market bias hone do, market direction hone do, it's all secondary. The first thing is your psychology and the first thing is your state of mind. Agar aap trading karne ke acche state mein ho, then only you have to trade or else you'll be making a lot of unforced errors. Matlab beech mein is yahan pe bhi, in this course also I made a lot of adjustments which were unnecessary. Unnecessary adjustments kiya and us unnecessary adjustments mein slippage mein 2 point idhar 2 point udhar jata raha tha. If you think in terms of points, 86,000 is less than 23-24 points. ठीक है, 23-24 points, मैंने 10-15 adjustment किया, हर एक adjustment में 2-2 point, 1-1 point slippage में जा रहा था, and because of that, वहीं पे almost 10-15 point वहीं पे है. If I hadn't committed those unforced errors, and if I hadn't, made those aggressive adjustments because of my own psychology, I think I would have broke even today. But, everything said and done, here we are, we took a hit of around 4% on the capital. So the thing is guys, no matter what style you're trading with, 4% in a single day is not actually advisable. ठीक है? Because two back-to-back days like this and add the charges, so you're down by 10%. So any account which has a drawdown of 10% or more is not a good style to trade with. So this shouldn't have happened, but it has happened. Let's acknowledge it, let's learn from it, and let's come back stronger. And yeah, sorry for not recording the whole trading session because I was not in the right state of mind. I was kind of getting frustrated. Usually main itna jaldi frustrated nahi hota hu, but today was one such day where everything started going haywire right from the start. We started off on the wrong foot and that kind of defined the whole day for me. So it's just part of the game and we will be facing these kinds of days quite often. And the market itself have been very punishing for the last couple of weeks. So not just me, everyone has been, the positional traders, the trend followers, and everyone, pretty much everyone has been kind of, getting chopped out by the markets. And that's the nature of markets, guys. Like you'll find like all kinds of markets. The easy markets are going to come, but it's just that we have to survive through these kinds of markets. If you see my expiry trading for the last 4 weeks, har ek expiry mein, usually market ne jo diya hai usko wapas leke ja raha hai. And a lot of my friends who do non-directional trading, usually they make losses during the expiries. The expiries have been extremely tough, the expiries have been extremely tricky, and they have been very tough to manage. Almost 1.5 months ke baad mera pehla loss ho raha hai एंड दिस लॉस थोड़ा बड़ा लॉस है, यस आई विल एक्सेप्ट दैट, बट काफी दिनों के बाद हो रहा है एंड आई थिंक दिस इज अ वेकअप कॉल. आई थिंक आई हैड बिकम अ बिट कॉकी और आई हैड बिकम अ बिट ओवर कॉन्फिडेंट इन टर्म्स ऑफ, हो सकता है कि आई हैड बिकम अ बिट ओवर कॉन्फिडेंट कि हर रोज प्रॉफिट हो रहा है, हर रोज आ रहा है करके. बट यस, दिस हैज बीन अ लेसन. सो लेट्स थैंक द मार्केट फॉर गेटिंग मी बैक ऑन ग्राउंड एंड लेट्स लर्न फ्रॉम दिस एंड लेट्स कम बैक स्ट्रॉन्गर. सी यू गाइस इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो.